থেকে আন্তরিক শুভেচ্ছা জানাচ্ছি। এবং আজকে আমরা একটা প্রোগ্রামের আয়োজন করেছি, ইনফ্যাক্ট ইয়াং স্কলার সিরিজ আমাদের বহু সময় ধরে এই প্যান্ডেমিক পিরিয়ডে চলছে। প্রদীপ্ত এক্স্যাক্টলি বলতে পারবে যে আজকে কততম এই ইয়াং স্কলার প্রেজেন্টেশন সিরিজ সিরিজের আজকে খুবই আমাদের মানে ভেরি উই আর ভেরি আনফর্চুনেট that we have lost one of our very important brained and valuable colleague and distinguished faculty তাকে আমরা হারিয়েছি। অরিন্দম সিনহা, অরিন্দমকে কম বেশি আমার ধারণা সবাই আমরা চিনি যারা পলিটিক্যাল সায়েন্স ফ্যাকাল্টির সঙ্গে যুক্ত, বিশেষ করে আমরা যারা সিনিয়র ফ্যাকাল্টি তারা ইনক্লুডিং শিবাজি বাবুর তো ছাত্র অরিন্দম অরিন্দম সিনহা ইনফ্যাক্ট কল্যাণী বিশ্ববিদ্যালয়ে আমার থেকে এক বছরে জুনিয়ার, অর্থাৎ ঠিক ইমিডিয়েটলি আফটার মাই ডিপার্চার ফ্রম কল্যাণী ইউনিভার্সিটি ইন 1988 অরিন্দম
রাজকুমার তোমার পরে
কিন্তু আমার একটা ইমোশনাল এবং সেন্টিমেন্টাল অ্যাটাচমেন্ট যেটা শিবাজিবাবু এবং কল্যাণবাবু খুব বেশি করে বুঝবেন বিকজ অফ কল্যাণী কানেকশন। হ্যাঁ,
আমরা
সবাই একই বিভাগের সঙ্গে যুক্ত ছিলাম মানে ছাত্রাবস্থায়, আর আপনারা সেখানে শিবাজিবাবু অধ্যাপনা করেছেন, আমাদের পড়িয়েছেন সেই সময়। তো যাই হোক, আমি অরিন্দমের এই অকাল মৃত্যুতে খুব মানে কম সময়ে মারা গেলেন, মানে বাকি জীবনের গোটা জীবনের অর্ধেকটাই বোধ হয় কভার করতে পারেননি। তো আমরা খুবই শোকস্তব্ধ এবং বেঙ্গল ইনস্টিটিউট অফ পলিটিক্যাল স্টাডিজ এর পক্ষ থেকে তাঁর আত্মার শান্তি কামনা করছি এবং ঈশ্বরের কাছে এটাই প্রার্থনা করছি যে যেখানেই থাকুন তিনি যেন শান্তিতে থাকেন, ভালো থাকেন, এইটাই কামনা করছি। এবং এক মিনিট আমরা একেবারে সাইলেন্স সবাই মিউট করে, জাস্ট আমি যখন এক মিনিট হয়ে যাবে আনমিউট করতে রিকোয়েস্ট করবো, তখন আমরা আবার ফিরে আসবো অরিন্দমের জন্য। আমরা এক মিনিট ঘড়ি ধরে একটা নিরাপত্তা পালন করছি। Let's start. আমরা এক মিনিট সমাপ্ত করেছি। আমি এরপরে আমাদের প্রদীপ্তকে অনুরোধ করব আজকের প্রোগ্রাম সম্পর্কে আমাদেরকে অবহিত করা এবং ফার্দার প্রোগ্রামটা পরিচালনার জন্য। প্রদীপ্ত প্লিজ। প্রদীপ্ত প্রদীপ্ত কি শুনছো?
এক মিনিট। Thank you.
তাহলে বিশ্বনাথ তুমি শুরু করো।
আচ্ছা
বিশ্বনাথ, বিশ্বনাথ শুরু করো। হ্যাঁ,
টু ফ্রেঙ্ক, আর টুডে উই হ্যাভ অ্যানাদার ইম্পর্টেন্ট লেকচার ফ্রম ইয়ং স্কলার অ্যান্ড ভেরি ইন্টারেস্টিং টপিক will be presented by Rita Dutta. She is assistant professor, Department of Political Science, Monindra Chandra College, Kolkata. She will speak on Roy and his city. All of we know about the famous Satyajit Ray and how he looks, how he views the city of Kolkata. So I think it will be very interesting lecture. And for after lecture, the two important researcher and scholar, also professor, will speak on the say on the commentary of Rita Dutta. We are honored to Rita, start.
Yeah, thank you. So like today I'm going to talk about Ray and his city, and I would like to thank Bengal Institute of Political Studies for providing me with the opportunity to present snippets from my area of interest. And also this is a platform for the first time. I'm going to celebrate Ray's birth centenary, which is coming next year. I sincerely thank my supervisor, Professor Bishwanath Chakraborty, Professor Shivaji Pratim Bosu, and Professor Bashubi Chakraborty, my seniors and my friends. A little prelude at the outset. The Lumiere brothers, as we all know, in 1895, first screened 46 seconds of film in Paris, and subsequently during their world tour, they screened another film in the famous Watson Hotel in Bombay. Resultantly, the first silent film screened in India was Raja Harishchandra by Dadasaheb Phalke, and the first talkie was Alomara, released in 1931. In Bengal, new theatres started making films in both Hindi and Bengali, often dubbed. Due to myriad reasons, new theatres started declining, and a new breed of individual producers emerged and brought in a new kind of cinema. Known as social melodramas, this period from mid-50s down 60s is commonly designated as Uttam Suchitra era, the golden period of Bengali cinema. This illustrious pair worked together from Share Chuhat 1953 to Priyo Bandhavi 1975 in a number of memorable films. The interesting part is when the whole Bengali middle class was crooning Tumi Je Amar from the film Haranushur, or এই পথ যদি না শেষ হয় সপ্তপদী the ritual of the seven steps in English 1961 and all seems glittery in the realm of cinema scope there appears few notable different kind of films which speaks of another city within the heavenly abode created by this pair So I'd like to mention Nagorik here for the first time in 1951 though it was created by this pair. So I'd like to mention Nagorik here for the first time in 1951 though it Pother Pachali Song of the Roads in 1955. Nagorik in fact is the first city film of a different nature. It is the trailblazer of the avant-garde cinema in Bengal. Now city becomes very important in the nation building process and the modalities of industrial development and the agenda of Nehruvian socialism centered on the city in this way the whole concept of postcolonial modernity and the importance of city became intertwined as a result city makes its headway in the realm of films in a more distinctive and prominent ways The city in films become an agglomeration of multiple variables. It not only contains the physical space, but engages itself in a profound narration of urban subjectivities. Therefore, the trauma, the pain of the city, and the malice, cinema engages itself with and becomes an archive. This relationship between cinema and city became the site where the questions of citizenship, modernity, tradition, dichotomy, the emerging crises such as divans, anomy, envy, and also the question of individual liberty, all of this found a space in the cinematic representation of the city. Therefore, cinema's relationship to the city remains both complex and historical. So I will like just pick up six films to elaborate on my argument. I have just barred Paresh Pathar here. So I will begin with Aparajito in 1956. Now Oppu of Pather Pachali in Aparajito had to travel to the then Calcutta city to realize his dreams. Before landing up in his final destination, Oppu makes a journey. From Nischindapur to Varanasi, back to Manushapota, and eventually to the city. This journey of an individual, says Ashish Nandi in his seminal work, An Ambiguous Journey to the City, that an individual has to take, I quote him, an epic journey to the poisoned city that becomes a nightmare and yet at the same time expands and enriches the self. Oppu landed in Harrison Road, enters Royal Press, studies in City College, and began his new life as a city dweller. Eventually started enjoying the freedom from old familial ties. Now in Oppur Sangsar, which is an extension of Aparajito, Oppur re-establishes his roots within the city through his conjugal space with Aparna, his wife. This, I quote Madhava Prasad here, desire for modernity, has been articulated and acknowledged in this film. Calcutta appears and reappears in this film in snippets. The protagonist moving in tram, horse-driven carriages, train lines near Tala Bridge, cinema hall, declares the physicality of the cinema in this, of the city in the cinema. But before Mahanagar, the big city, the English name, 1963, 142 minutes running time, Calcutta never became an agenda in Ray's oeuvre. He was then so preoccupied with the past and Tagore. Although he lived in the city, there was no correspondence between him and the poetry of anguish which has dominated Bengal so very much at that hour. It is in Mahanagar that for the first time Ray was trying to make a statement about the city and its trajectory. His brilliant craftsmanship, eye for nuances, turned the city into a separate character in itself. And this is Ray's statement on the city and its women and her awakening to the possibility of determining the course of her life. Aruti, played by legendary Madhumi Mukherjee, and I quote Chidananda Dasgupta, film critic, who mentioned umpteen times that Ray found his man in Soumitra Chatterjee and his woman in Madhumi Mukherjee. Here the protagonist has the glimpse of a world where she is somebody in her own right. The English name of Mahanagar was a big city and it focused on the lower middle class family in Calcutta. The city was then troubled by the sudden leap from colonialism to independence and trying to fight the major debacle called partition, which witnessed the sudden the steady influx of refugees and inflation of population and migration. The Mojumdar family, where Arothi belongs to, represented the numerous lower middle class families migrated from villages and trying to cope with the challenges posed by the big metropolis. The city at first attacked the feudal tendencies of any Indian family. The house where Mojumdars reside, like any other household, gave utmost importance to familial values rather than sheer individualism. Mohanagar, in a way, was prophetic in terms of imagining a futuristic dystopic city space. Arothi and millions of women like her were still trying to strike a balance between home and workplace. Her sudden resignation from the job reconfirmed her sense of self-determination. The accidental tryst with the city thus proved to be a boon for Arothi, who otherwise would have spent a non-occasional life throughout. The city was always there, looming large over the characters, but more subtly than the aggressive Calcutta triptych, which means trilogy, I quoted Professor John Hood here. Now, I will little bit theorize here, like, the view of scopophilia, which is extremely popularized by famous American theoretician Laura Mulvey in her Visual Pleasure and Additive Cinema, the seminal work. She explained how women are exhibited in the mainstream films and they are, I quote her, bearer of the meaning, not the maker of it. Now, Mulvey argues that Laka's psychoanalytical theory is the key to understanding how film carries a space for female objectification. But interestingly, Mohanagar was different. It provides its protagonist an agency to assert. Now, I'm skipping a few parts, okay? The ensuing decades from mid-60s witnessed the unfolding of series of political skirmishes. The sharp increase in political violence that accompanied governmental instability, typified by rebellion in Naxalbari, continued for a long period of time. Certain sections of the city emerged as a crucial site for political and cultural subversion. Now, with Calcutta trilogy, Ray, I'm not mentioning Ghatak and Shen here, Bengali cinema as a whole moved beyond the existing patterns and threw up new ideological aspects and prototypes. Now, at this crucial hour, Ray made three films consecutively, which can be taken as his comment on the city. They all depict the lives of young educated men and women and how the life of city determined their psyche. Politically, he was inclined towards leftism but never joined a party. Manik is far more an individualist to be a communist, says his cousin Nini. The ferocious changes taking places in the city kind of compelled him to consider the city as a project cinematically. Ray remembered city as a nightmare city, and according to the letters written to Marie Siton, his biographer, the author of Portrait of a Director, he even considered leaving the city. I quote Ray through Marie Siton, "For me, Calcutta is a place to work, the place to live, so you take what it comes, you accept the fact of change," unquote. What triggered Ray to consider Calcutta, the city he resides in, to be the recurrent theme of his famous triptych is a series of events taken place in the 70s. In 1969, United Front came to power. Ray welcomed this change, hoping this regime to be better than erstwhile Congress rule. But he proved to be wrong, and in July, he wrote to his biographer Siton again, I quote, "The political situation is getting so rough here that I'm beginning to worry about any Calcutta project." He was touted as a self-betraying bourgeois who had no qualms to comment on the happenings of the city. Even his very dear friend Chidananda Dasgupta objected. He said that, I quote Chidananda here, "Calcutta of the burning drums, communal riots, refugees, unemployment, rising prices, and food shortages," unquote, was never evident in his films. Then after 2 years, the political situation became so compelling that he felt this is the time to take the city seriously. Sunil Gangopadhyay's Pratidwandi, The Adversary, 1970, was the opportunity he was waiting for. He read Pratidwandi in October 1969 and went to make the film in February 1970. By May, with the film can in hand, he wrote to Siton again, "The present explosive atmosphere here on anarchy and revolution and violent anti-American feeling. I'm pretty tense about the possible reaction to my film. Anyways, these three trilogies also produced a conscious subversion of the popular cinematic form of Bengal at that time. So I moved to Pratidwandi, The Adversary, where we all know, we have seen the film, so I picked up these films particularly. So Siddhartha, the protagonist, is an emblem of urban despair, which brings in it with radical violence as well as middle-class fear, anxiety, and desperation, and whose leaders would arbitrarily determine the destinies of thousands of young people like him. The city is a formidable adversary to people like Siddhartha with no means. This film is a collection of modernist moments, but with a thread of a narrative that carries a still barely surviving humanist ontology of a person. The Calcutta trilogy is about haunted films, film recording the spectrality of the modern city, a place of memories, desires, and zombies. The protagonists are part of the city they inhabit, and they are typically ignored by it. The city consumes and neglects them. Now, interviews form a very significant part of Siddhartha's life because he had to leave his medical studies abruptly for taking care of the family. Interviews are treacherous, manipulative, and full of nepotism. After such an unsuccessful interview, Siddhartha goes to a cinema hall where a documentary is showing the glittering prospect of Indian nation, and a bomb is blasted inside the hall, an everyday phenomena of the life at that hour. He visits his friend in a mess. They later went to watch a Swedish film in a film society, which is incidentally established by Satyajit Ray and his friends, the Calcutta Film Society, in 1947. In one of the interviews, Siddhartha expressed his solidarity to the Vietnamese movement as the most important human achievement of the decade than their landing in Moon. And throughout the film, Siddhartha looks for a certain bird, which actually symbolizes his lost innocence in the city. But finally, he hears that bird song when he has to take up a job in a pharmaceutical company in the countryside, only to rediscover the optimism of life still offers him. Now, I move to Shimabaddho now, raise another commentary, from a very different perspective. He perhaps tried to locate the areas from where all these disturbances is occurring. The rampant corruption, inhuman self-interest, which makes people like Shyamalendu is the protagonist of Shimabaddho, who is materially successful, on the other hand, produce people like Tunu is the brother of Siddhartha in Adversary, who at least tries to resist and change the existing social order. He was a Naxalite. Now, Shyamalendu migrates to the city from the village and find prosperity through Hindustan Peters, a UK-based company known for the manufacture of fans. And in his household party, we can see a different city within the city itself. Like their aversion, when in a conversation, we can see Shyamalendu and his friends and their aversion to the formation of labor unions, student movements, urgent need of dictatorship, virtually indicated the emergency period imposed on the state at around that time, because Himabadho was produced in 1970. He hatches a plan with Horihar, finally, the labor officer of the company, and saves the company from losing its reputation. As a result, he was rewarded for his service, but his triumph was anti-cinematic. When Tutul, sister-in-law, brilliantly played by Shamila Tagore, in the last shot, returns his watch, this was emblematic about the upper-class hypocrisy as well as the kind of protest on Tutul's part, because she is the conscience keeper here. I move to Janavar Onno, the last one, and I will wrap up very soon. Middleman, 1976. The protagonist, Shomnath, as we all know, Pradeep Mukherjee, like he, even being a good student, failed to secure the coveted marks, and Ray, with his trademark of extreme subtlety, investigates the otherwise hilarious reasons behind it. The wretchedness of the examiner, the poor eyesight, the inability to procure glasses, rampant low shedding, the domestic inconvenience, all resulted in improper assessment of the answer scripts, which in fact decided the destiny of a poor chap like Shomnath and his world went topsy-turvy. So after a series of events, which we see in this in the film, he actually resort to a kind of you know, moral corruption. So, cinematically, when Somnath is strolling through the streets of Calcutta in need of a job, we can witness the graffiti on the wall, China chairman is our chairman, a quotation, Naxalite sown by. So this is the way Calcutta becomes alive through that film. To survive, these young people have to imbibe moral corruption. The city with its youth succumbs to the plight, indignant to his own wretchedness. Somnath harbors the path of doing petty business. He becomes a middleman. And finally, eventually, we see that he ended up delivering a girl who happens to be Koruna, his friend Somnath's sister, to a scornful businessman in a shady hotel, which caused him enormous amount of moral loss, a phenomena that city bears testimony of. Now I wrap up that Mahanagar, this is very important, I think, that Mahanagar made in 1964 ended in a positive note, as both the characters were still hoping to find a job in a big city. In Pratidwandi, 1970, Siddhartha had to escape the dystopic city to find solitude. He journeyed back to the village. Shyamalendu's disintegrity is in Simabaddho, 1971, is somehow thwarted by his conscience keeper Tutul, but in Janoharono, 1976, Somnath succumbs to the conspiracy of the poisoned city, as mentioned before. In this way, the trilogy seems to deal with the problems only obliquely in Ray's subtle aesthetic ways. Therefore, Ray's city films formed an archive of the city and its history, as this genre of cinema interrogates, negotiates, and engages the city in multiple ways. Thank you.
Thank you, Rita. I think a very short but very nice presentation covering almost all the important aspects. I must communicate to all the participants that Rita is simply not a teacher of political science. Rita is a renowned film critic, and well-known film critic, not only in our country, but throughout the world, because she visited frequently different parts of the world. I have some memory I can communicate to you, that Rita visited Brazil International Film Festival as a critic and a jurist. She visited several times China as a jurist in International Film Festival. She acted as a jurist in Tajikistan and other different, so many different International Film Festival. She contributed her experience as a jurist or as a critic. And apart from that, she is well known scriptwriter in Bengal film industry. So she has her own world, and very few of us know about her own world that has been created by Rita. So I'm really thankful, Rita, that within a few minutes, the way you have presented the whole thing, it is really appreciable. But may I now request Professor Shivaji Pratim Bosu, renowned scholar in our time, and also the Dean of Arts, Vidyasagar University, and Professor of Department of Political Science, Vidyasagar University, please make comment on the presentation, and if you want to add, you can do that. Okay, sir. Thank you.
First, I must... Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
First, I want to congratulate Rita for this presentation. In a very short period, Vishwanath requested me to be present and just for an hour and to have, you know, two commentators. I couldn't think how could that happen. Rita, one thing I must say, that your presentation was very good. It has your languages. You have also commented on the language. Very theoretical, very racy and poignant, and that is very good. And I didn't know that you have been the part of juries in different film festivals around the world. So very happy to know that, and congratulations on that, and also on today's presentation.
Thank you, sir.
But I expected some clippings of, you know, clippings.
I couldn't do it. Sir, I couldn't do it.
Some clippings could have been more, more attractive for this presentation, because, you know, these are, you are, you belong to also political, you belong to political science.
Yes,
you belong to political science, and also you have a world, you have a niche world, that world that you have created. But many of the, I don't know, I don't know much of the members, I don't know much about the members of this organization, BIPS. But I think, that is my general idea, I may be wrong, I'll be happy if I am proved wrong, that most of them have just heard the names of some of the films, but did not have, because many of them are very youngsters, and these films do not come again and again, and whenever, you know, it appears, these films appear on television, there are so many advertisements, people get bored and then change the channel, start the channel. So that is my presentation, Vishwanath. Yes, I don't know whether you will agree or not, but I think some important parts. And just yesterday, when I was going through an article of Anibandha, I call him Anibandha, Aniban Chattopadhyay. It was on, and he referred to, in the post-edit article of Anand Bajaj yesterday. Then I got the news of Arindam. And I sent him a message that I am so shocked and why, but Anibandha mentioned this this interview where Siddhartho was appearing in interview after interviews, and bizarre questions are being asked, and this questioning, and also in Shomnath, in Jonwar or no, there also they were people were asking questions just to deny you your job. For answering, then one question is, what is the weight of, what is the mass weight of the moon? Chande Rojon. So that was a Chande Rojon. So that kind of absolutely bizarre questions just to deny job to a middle class, very otherwise able person on whose shoulder the entire family stood. And so these things, and my personal, I am a Calcuttan. I was born in, my desh is Kolkata, because my forefathers, they have settled in Kolkata in 1905 from East Bengal. And from that time, from 1905, our family is living in Kolkata. So my desh is Kolkata. I am a Calcutta nationalist. So Ray was also like that, because Upendra Kishan and I spent my childhood, that is Supia Street. There, and at that time, it was also Supia Street. Ray was born on nearby Gorpal Road, where the Athenaeum School is there. And you find the name, mentioning of Athenaeum School many times in Feluda novels. And then also Santosh Kumar Dutta, he was my father's friend. My father was a lawyer. Santosh Babu was a Jatayu, Jatayu. Many things in, Raja in Guga Baba. That is Ubi Gai Bhagavad, you see. Mm-hmm. So that is a kind of Calcutta. Ray was basically a Calcutta man. And he contacted with, got to know about nature when he joined Shanti Niketan. Before that, he was absolutely westernized, although he had that kind of Baligon government school, Bengali English mixed kind of education, then Presidency College, of course, and Chidananda Dasgupta, the father of Aparna Sen. He was his classmate and all long time friends. One thing, I think this is not a comparison, this is a very good presentation. Anyway, Vishwanath, am I crossing my limits of time?
No. You can have 3-4 minutes more. Please do that.
3-4 minutes. Okay. I will take another 3-4 minutes. The president gives his verdict, like the Supreme Court trusted on us. Okay. So I'll stick to my time. So these kind of, so she was in the love of the city. The city means actually she loved the Saheb Para of Kolkata more, I think. But later he wanted to portray Kolkata in a different way. And this street, Calcutta trilogy, everybody knows. And in fact, an aged person I had gone through this. I was a paka bacha for my age always. I read, Koribye Kinlam when I was in class three. And so I read in these two of these, Pashupidi will bear me out, that two of these novels by Shankar, these two, Shimabadhwa and Janoro, written by Shankar. Shankar, it appeared in Sharodiya Desh. So we read Sharodiya Desh, and I read Sunil Babu's, Sunilda's, I called him Sunilda when he was alive. Sunil Ganguly's Pratidum. And Mahanagar, the actual name of Mahanagar, the Noren Mitro, famous, sociologist Obijidda. Obijidda, I call him Obijidda, Obijid Mitro's father. Where Joya Bhaduri appeared for the first time in this film, the original novel was known as Abhutaronika. So Abhutaronika, it was named renamed. And Ray always worked with best literature. Yes. Best literature. He was a literature-based, novel-based or literature-based director. But he transformed the realities of literature in a very cinematic way, in a way that it became another thing. It became another form of creativity. And always he worked also with the best actors available at that time. He worked with Uttam Kumar, there was a possibility of also taking in Suchitra Sen in some of his films. So all these things, this city, শহর গিলে খায় আমাদের শহর আমাদের গিলে খায় মহানগর ক্রমশ গিলে খায় এখানে অনেকে আসে লাইক বাট হিয়ার দিস ইউ হ্যাভ অলসো আই ডোন্ট নো ওয়াই অপুর সংসার অপু কামস টু কলকাতা হি ইজ কামিং ফ্রম আউটসাইড বাট আদারওয়াইজ অল দ্য আদার ফোর ইনক্লুডিং মহানগর মোস্ট অফ দিস নভেলস আর বেসিক্যালি বেসড অন দ্য প্রোটাগনিস্টস who basically are from Kolkata. They are indigenously from Kolkata. So these are two distinctions from Opur Shongshai and other four. Abhutaronika, that is Mahanagar, Din Pratidwandi, these are all the names that he did not change the name. Mahanagar, Din Pratidwandi, then Shimabadhwa, and then John Oro. So it is really, I think, for political scientists also, we have to, urban studies are very, very promising site, urban studies, how the cities came. And he also, she mentioned about, Rita mentioned about one philia, that is copophilia, some Lacanian thing that how you are projecting women. He is a Gurudev of Indian film. I am not criticizing him, but I will just remind one scene presented by Ray, presented by Satyajit Ray in Pratidwandi, against which the Nurses Association of Bengal, they protested because he put Miss Shefali. Shefali was a very famous bar dancer at that time, or cabaret dancer, as a nurse who leads a kind of very loose kind of life, where Siddhartha reaches her flat with his friend, And you know, she was a kind of a public woman also at when she was also a nurse. So that kind of that scopophilia, that was a kind of a representation of woman of a particular profession. So that was, you know, at that time enraged the nurses of Kolkata and other places. Well, but I will not. I have taken much of the time. Vishwanath knows that it is. I become very unstoppable sometimes. So it's a favorite subject. I can go on speaking for hours and engage with Rita. I'm very happy that you have a member in Weaves who, you know, generally political scientists take shukno time. So that kirakum perspective and all this. Enjoy life, let us enjoy life. And politics is everywhere, you know. Here is also politics. Yes. We have to discover politics everywhere. Yes. Thank you so much, and thank you, Vishwanath, for bearing me so much and for giving me an opportunity to be with you.
Thank you, Shivajita. We are really thankful to Shivajita that because he is really busy at this movement after the judgment from Supreme Court. Because he is in important post of the Vidyasagar University, so he has lot of series of meetings with his university authority. So once again, from BIPS, we are really thankful. Please stay with us. Hope in future also we get you in our platform also, Shivajita. But I must say that the way you presented and made comment. It's very learning for us. It's very much learning for all of us, and of course, thought provoking. May I now request Professor Bashogi Chakraborty? She is the faculty member, Department of Sociology, Rabindra Bharati University. Bashogi is also very known. She is very known for her engagement with poetry, Bengali poetry. She has written a lot of books on a poem, a Bengali poem, and definitely one of the important contributor in social science in present time. So may I request now Bashogi Chakraborty to present her view. Bashogi, can you unmute yourself, please? Just you have a button, you can unmute on. Please unmute. No. Still, no. Not happen. You see, unmute. There is a microphone, symbol of microphone. Just click on it. Then it will be unmute. Otherwise, we cannot hear you. No.
আপনার মোবাইলে দেখুন তিনটে বাটন আছে একটা রেড তার মধ্যে একটা সিম্বল আছে ক্রস সেইটাকে আপনাকে আনমিউট করতে হবে.
Now,
please continue. First of all, I would like to extend my thanks to Professor Vishwanath Chakraborty for inviting me as discussion. Of the Bengal Institute of Political Studies, and I would like to share my views on this topic as said by Rita Dattu on Ray and the City. And I also like to say that I am not an expert on this topic, being a sociologist and an ardent lover of art, poetry, and film. I am a fan of Satyajit Ray. So from this viewpoint and also as a sociologist, I would like to share my views and to say a few words. We know that in Ray's films, Calcutta appears often as a frame of reference, so, sometimes at an adversary, as said by Rita, and often in the background and sometimes as dominant. And individual beings live and survive sometimes innocently, sometimes accusing, not in frequently with a sense of guilt and a troubled conscience in a society which is fast changing. And I have mentioned earlier that city assumes much importance to Satyajit. Why? Shivaji Pratim Bosu also, because to Satyajit, Calcutta is much more than a living presence, because it is in his bloodstream. A third generation Calcuttans, they grew in the city, passing through into post profound changes and also transition. And Ray also personally experienced the trauma that metamorphized the city and his psyche. Ray also allowed himself to be exposed to all the influences that the city brought to bear on him, for he likes big cities to engulf and to bewilder him. It is very important to note that he took the adversity in his stride and therefore could see both faces of the city. It is very important, the both faces of the city, one is humanizing and the other is dehumanizing. And Roy tried to capture this flux through his film, which would quite naturally be informed by a vision that is essentially urban. And here I would like to add that Ray's love for the city was well expressed in an interview. Interview was taken by Bet Mehta almost 40 or 45 years ago, where Ray said, "I love Calcutta. I have lived here my life. The best of whatever is being done in the arts in India, in India, is being done here. There is a great intellectual vitality, and from a filmmaker's point of view, no city than Calcutta could be better." Though it shows or it unravels his love for the city. And Rita, in her presentation, already presented a chronological array from Mahanagar to the Calcutta trilogy named Pratidwandi, Simabaddho, and Janaranya. But I have a question to Rita. Why Rita have not incorporated any discussion on Devi or Charulata? All these are also these filmed in the frame of the city. And in other films like the Kanchanjanga and Anandindin Datti or Nayok or Sonar Kella, here also the main characters are from the metropolis. Though the perspective is not like the city, but the characters are from the metropolis. And Rita very aptly mentioned the Calcutta trilogy, where Ray, in these three films, Pratidwandi, Simabaddho, and Janaranya, which is called the Calcutta trilogy, Ray, through his with great artistic skills, and through these three films, tried to show the chronicle in the city's development in the last 100 years. So Calcutta of mid-19th century, which I like to say, is glimpsed in Devi, which symbolizes the newly awakened spirit through Uma Prasad, fighting his goddess addict superstitious father, whose irrational belief leads to the human tragedy. And both in Devi and Charulata, the Calcutta of the last century, that is the 19th century, has been framed, viewed from the angle of the landed aristocracy, with superb grace, more through image, sounds, and suggestions, which have heightened the human drama instead of overshadowing it. Rita already mentioned about the Aparajito and Upur Shongar and all these three films. And I would also request Rita to incorporate in his discussion on the last film of Ray, that is the Agontuk, The Stranger, 1991. This is his last film, the film based on his own, one of his own short story, Otithi. He had Mohan, he's an anthropologist, and he came to Calcutta to meet her niece, only surviving niece, Anila, and that great-hearted man and this fast-educated man whose only motive is to wander from one country to another. When he came to visit her niece, the urban people, especially the family man and the outside, all are being guided by some suspicious motive, because they began to believe that he has come with some purpose. But after the end of the film, we come to know that his only motive is to meet her niece. And when the couple, Anila and her husband, apologize and request Manmohan Mitra to stay with them, then he was not agreed, and he just he back to Calcutta for their request. But what they don't believe is that she comes here with some purpose. That is not true, because at last, when he left for Australia, he renounces his share of property. So this film is, I will request Rita to incorporate in his discussion. And lastly, I have some an own view regarding this topic. When Vishwanath requested me to share my views on this topic, then I started to think over it, that how Rita will connect this concept, there's a Ray and his city, with the political perspective, because as a researcher of political science, he should do it. And when I started to think about it, I remembered the famous urban sociologist Louis Pumphord saying on city, according to Mumford, little communal village cells undifferentiated, every part performing equally every function, turned into complex structure, organized on an axiate principle with differentiated tissues and specialized organisms, and with one part, the central nervous system, thinking for and directing the whole. So this is the image of the city as a social organism. Here we should note that the term city, of course, has many meanings, and many meanings to many men. But the main, the prominent meaning is that, and that the common conception as legal and political. That is, the city is regarded as a kind of corporate entity possessing certain delegated power. So from this viewpoint, I think Rita's topic that she selected is relevant, and for the perspective of the urban sociologist, and from the standpoint of the film of Ray, the Ray and the City is very relevant and important. Because Ray himself is a ardent lover of Calcutta, and he also filmed 36 films has been, I think, done by Ray, and almost 10 or 6 to 10 films, except his many films are most of the films are city-centric or urban-centric. So from this viewpoint, I say that Rita's presentation is... incorporate more films which is city-centric or urban-centric. And that will... because this is a PhD dissertation. So I think that in this perspective, the inclusion of these queens will enrich our discussion on Ray and City and make it more comprehensive.
Okay.
Thank you, Vishwanath and others who are associated with Bengal Institute of Political Studies for inviting me and share my views on this topic. Thank you again.
Okay. Thank you, Vashmidi, making so many remarks and so many important comments on the presentation of Rita Datto. May I now request Rita Datto, Rita, if you make another comment on two important presentations from Professor Shivaji Pratim Basu and Dr. Bashumi Chakraborty, if you like to make any comment.
No, there's nothing to comment. I have actually, there's some echo going on. Somebody has to mute his or her audio.
Okay, continue.
There's nothing to, actually I have incorporated whatever Professor Basu and Professor Chakraborty have mentioned. But the point is, first of all, this is not my part of my PhD dissertation as such. This is part of my one of my articles I have written. And just because of lack of time, I couldn't incorporate all the films, because to discuss Ray, we need probably more than one day. And I couldn't incorporate the slides and videos because of the lack of time, because I thought either I can make a presentation or I can, you know, to do justice to both is a little difficult, actually, in this stipulated time. So this is my logic, but of course I have incorporated whatever Professor Basu and Professor Chakraborty have said, but I wanted to concentrate on the City trilogy, actually. And as a prelude, I talked about Oku and Oku Shongshar and about the journey of Oku to the city. And of course, the rest of the people, as Professor Basu mentioned, they are urban youth. They are born into the city. So maybe in some later period of time, in the platform of Peeps, I can elaborate on that with, of course, video clippings. Because to explain cinema is very, very difficult without, you know, the cinematic presentation in itself. So I will do it. But actually, because of lack of time, I couldn't. Sorry, that is my fault, of course.
Unmute for Vishwanath, unmute for.
Before opening for all, may I request our President Rajkumar Kothari and our Vice President Uddalok Roy to make, if you have any comment on this presentation.
No, as such, there is no comment. Very excellent presentation. I thoroughly enjoyed the presentation made by Vita, and the subsequent two discussants made remarkable comments in respect of the presentation, one by Professor Shivaji Pratim Basu and second one by Madam Bashumi Chakraborty. And I had the same impression like Madam, because I thought this is your PhD topic, Rita. So I was wondering that how you are going to connect it with the political science discipline.
No. Hello. Can I say something?
Yes.
Yeah, my PhD topic is the working title. The title is City and Cinema, an Interface, and the time period is 1947 to 77. Ray's City Films forms a part of it, not the whole of it.
Okay. So, thank you. And on the screen, there is a very important question by Pranotha Bhattacharya. If you can address that question, that is 1756, it has been posted. If you just check, and if you wish to react to that question.
Okay, Uddalokda, are you available, Uddalok Roy? Okay, Rita, now if you have you seen this question?
Yeah.
Okay, can you address?
I don't know. I mean, can she talk and ask me the question? I mean, Mrinal Sen's City trilogy depicted post-humanism as theorized by Francesca Fernando. Yeah, of course, there are different ways of seeing Meenakshi's Calcutta Trilogy, and Francesca's theory is one of it. I cannot differ from there. Of course, there is.
Okay. So if you have any question, participant, you can raise this question. Abhishek, Kollan Kumar Sarkar and others, if you have any observation, please.
First of all, I extend my thanks to Rita Dotto. She has depicted the city, the life of Kolkata, depicted by Satyajit Ray. It is very plausible that it is not possible for her to cover up all the films of city dwelling depicted by Ray. However, his presentation, I have enjoyed thoroughly the presentation. I was surprised to know that she has covered up the films, significant films of Satyajit Ray, especially the interview of Siddhartha, especially the life of Somnath, etc. It is important. Satyajit Ray has very nicely dealt with the interview that it is Vietnamese war is better than landing on moon. The ground, the plausible answers of Siddhartha is very interesting and very illuminating. She has he has told that Siddhartha has answered that the landing on the moon will be happened later on, but Vietnamese war has revolutionarily changed the social life of the people. This answer is very good, and Madam Rita has mentioned of all these. Last of all, I am very much delighted to see Sibaji Pratim Basu and Basuvidhi. Basuvidhi belongs to Ranagat. I am also a man of Ranagat. I am delighted to see all these two discussions, and it is interesting that the discussion of Madam Ray, Madam Mirza, is very fine and interesting. I have a little submission to her that Pratidwandi may be translated into as competitor rather than adversary. It is my humble submission to Rita, Madam. Pratidwandi means competitor, one who competes, rather than adversary. Whatever it is, she has presented very nicely. She has dealt on this topic very good, and within a few minutes, I think 25 to 26 minutes, she has dealt with all these topics. I convey my thanks to him, and I convey my congratulations to all the participants of this, Rajkumar Kothari and Vishwanath Bhattacharya.
Okay, Shibaji, do you have any comment on Pratidwandi translation?
No. These are the names given in the English version of the versions of the film. These are the middleman. So John Oronu is not translated as middleman. So these are the names given by Ray when it was music room. Music room is Dolsha Ghor or something else. And so these things are given by Ray himself in the English versions when these are the names given by Ray.
Okay.
And you pointed out Pratidwandi should be competitor, but then how John Oronu, the mob forest or the something, mob forest kind of, the mob jungle of mob. So that is not, so it was middleman. So that these names were given by not Rita, Ray himself. That it, one thing that I wanted to, I forgot rather, it's very fascinating. So many discussions, so many points are coming and people are loving to comment. So this is an interesting presentation, this has been. That you can, in your PhD study, Rita, you can go for one comparison, although you should not, you can also stick to yourself. also Sen has also Vinal Sen. I mean Vinal Sen. Vinal Sen's Calcutta trilogy. There also we had that kind of interview. And
sir, I have incorporated Ghatak and Sen in my PhD thesis.
Okay.
Both. Thank you
so much. Thank you.
Okay.
Pradipta, are you available? Pradipta?
Yes, sir.
Achha, before Pradipta, because I would like to request Pradipta to conclude with vote of thanks. But before that, if you have any question, any query, any comment, any observation, please come forward and do that. Otherwise, Pradipta, you can render vote of thanks.
Well, it's a proud privilege for me to deliver the vote of thanks. We have the honor to have with us Professor Shivaji Pratim Bosu from Vidyasagar University and Dr. Bashobi Chakraborty of Rabindra Bharati University. It is also my proud privilege to have Shivaji Pratim Bosu, as I have been taught by him in Rabindra Bharati University in few classes. Thank you, sir, for being with us in our platform, that is BIPS. And I thank our beloved students who have joined in this special lecture delivered by Rita Dotto of Shambhajar College. She has delivered a wonderful lecture on Ray and at the city and his view on the city. And I would also like to thank our Honorable President, Professor Rajkumar Kothari of Vidyasagar University, our Honorable Secretary, the Professor Vishwanath Chakraborty, our Vice President, Dr. Udalok Rai, our Joint Secretary, Dr. Debashish Nandi, and without whom we cannot hold this kind of webinars or lectures. Those are Dr. Abhishek Kormokar, Devtonu Maji and Shukdev Das, and thanks to all. Thanks for joining the special lecture of BIPS. With this, I conclude the session. Thank you.
Thank you.